In this tutorial, I'll show you how to automatically generate free subtitles for your video projects in DaVinci Resolve. Welcome to this video. My name is David and I hope you're well wherever you are around the world. Now, we are talking about the free version of DaVinci Resolve. We all know it does not come with the automatic transcription and subtitling feature that is available in the paid version, DaVinci Resolve Studio. So for this, we're going to be using AutoSubs, and version 3 is powerful, comes as a standalone, and also as a one that you can use in the free version of DaVinci Resolve, even the paid one. Now, I've already downloaded and installed, so you need to download and install AutoSubs, this version 3, and I've gone ahead, downloaded it, and installed it on my computer right here. So once that is done, then you can come back and open up DaVinci Resolve. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a new project. You can call it whatever. I'm just going to leave it as Untitled 3. Next up, I'm going to go into the cut or edit section here and just drag and drop my file right there. Just click on change. And from here, you can just create a new timeline from selected clips. So I'm going to make sure that it starts at 00. Remember, you can always change this in the preferences, because when it comes to subtitles, the timing is very, very important, especially if you're going to export those subtitles for somebody else to do work on them or anything of that sort. Once your timeline is set, just click on create. So we've got our video there and it's ready to go. Because we've already downloaded and installed AutoSubs, all you need to do is now go to up here to workspace and then scripts and then click on AutoSubs. Once I click on that, it's going to open up AutoSubs, and by default, it's going to go into the Resolve kind of window here. Or if you wanted to use it as a standalone, you can click on this. But let's go to Resolve. And one thing you'll take a note of is that it's connected. So before you do all this, you always need to create a timeline so that the timeline is recognized. So if it's not recognized, you can always click on refresh so that it's actually connected. If there was no timeline, you'd see a red with disconnected indicated right there. So what's the audio track that we want? We want the audio track. As you can see, if we move this to the side, it's audio track one right here. That is the one that we want. We can scroll down. So the output track, we've got either add it to a new track or video one. We'll have it add to new track. And the reason for this is if you put it on video one, that is where your base video is. Nothing is kind of going to happen, and you'll not notice your subtitles there. The base template, we're going to go with the default, this one. Once we select this particular option here, then right here in this folder, there's a default template that you can always make edits to. Let's go back to the master and bring up AutoSubs again. And you can select all the different languages here. And also of importance is the transcription model. You can choose the model that you want right here. And this is based on OpenAI's Whisper. You can go with the big models that, if you have the RAM and all that, that are actually going to give you better accuracy and all that. And then you can set dynamic time wrapping for improved subtitle alignment, and also GPU acceleration if you have a graphics processing unit. And then these are the subtitle rules that you can set up here. And you can continue like that. So let's assume all the settings as we want them to be. Just click on start transcription. And because that's a short video, it's going to export the audio, and then the transcription process is going to begin. Transcription complete. If you'd like to edit the subtitles, click continue editing. When you're ready, click the orange button to add them to the timeline. Now, you can click on continue editing. And from here, I know this one particular word is a little bit, has an issue. So I can actually come here and just descripts and then remove this one. So right there, click on save changes. I think that's the only issue I know. And then once I'm satisfied, I'm going to, I just wanted to move it somewhere we might actually see what's going on. I'll click on add to timeline. And once I do that, you're going to see a new layer come in here with a text plus. And if I minimize this and then play our video,
In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use Descript's eye contact feature to simulate eye contact with the camera even when you're reading from a script. Welcome to this video. My name is David and I hope you're well wherever you are around the world.
So, looks good. It's using the default template right here. But all we wanted for this video is how to automatically generate free subtitles in DaVinci Resolve, the free version. And as you can see, it's the text plus layer. And from here, you can see what sort of edits have been done to that so that you can also make your changes right there, depending on what you see needs to be changed right there. And then, so everything as it is based on the default template. You can always create your own templates to use with this particular version. Now, that's it for this video. And that is how you can automatically generate free subtitles in DaVinci Resolve, the free version. I hope this video is of value to you. Thanks for watching.